As the world grapples with the reality of COVID-19, lifestyles are changing and new ways of living adopted. PLUS TV Africa spoke with Patrick Egwu, journalist from Johannesburg, South Africa, who shares his experience.
Hey, Amaka, sorry about the noise. It's actually the TV at the background. So I'm going to do another one, you know. So the situation is that starting from tomorrow, the coronavirus situation in South Africa is that starting from tomorrow, there's going to be a lockdown, you know, a total lockdown of the whole of South Africa. I mean, the whole 9 provinces we have in South Africa is going to be on lockdown. And the president, Cyril Ramaphosa, actually made the announcement 2 days ago. But that was after wide consultation with relevant stakeholders in the health sector and especially the National Command Center on Coronavirus in South Africa. And they felt that the best thing to do was just to put the country on lockdown as a way of, you know, combating the increasing rates of, you know, of the virus in the country headlong. Just last week in South Africa, we had, you know, 63 cases of the virus, you know, 63 cases of the virus in the country. But presently we have more than 700 cases in the country. And, you know, it keeps increasing by the day. It keeps going up. And people think, you know, it's going to keep, you know, moving up if nothing is done about it. So many people actually applauded the moves by the government to put the country on lockdown. And if you go out now, many people are trying to do the final arrangements, the final, buying and all that. And actually, there is panic buying in South Africa. I was at the mall yesterday, and you could see the way people were trying to get everything that they need, you know, that they'll be needing during the 21 days lockdown. And I can tell you, it's going to be a very long 21 days, you know, staying indoors with your family and without moving anywhere. So the only people who are allowed to move about are those they call the essential service personnel. And we are talking about doctors, nurses, and those who work with financial institutions, money deposits, offices, and all that. And if you want to get, you know, some drug supplies, they can allow you because pharmacies are open.